Welcome one and all to our Excellence Academy AMIE online coaching. Today we are going to look into the introduction of Excellence Academy. Okay, so you guys have registered with us or you are planning to register to join our online coaching, isn't it? So you should know what online coaching is, who we are and how we work and interact with you guys, right? So that basic information is needed before proceeding further, right? Please interact with me through chat window so that I'll be aware. Good, thank you. Excellence Academy, AMIE online coaching, our slogan is learn simply, learn more. You can understand from our slogan, right? I would like you all to read this quote aloud, okay? If you can, read it aloud. Good morning, Jyoti. Yes, I'm not here to be average. I'm here to be awesome. Okay, who we are? You would have already seen the internet, who we are. Okay, but anyway, once again, I'll tell you. So the senior members, the seniors for you guys, AMIE senior staff, okay? In earlier days, okay, before you had all these online coaching and before you had these facilities, the juniors weren't able to catch up with the seniors. You know how seniors help us a lot? You can get a lot of guidance from the seniors, isn't it? They would give you notes, they would give you tips. I think I'm right. So there wasn't any interaction with the seniors for the juniors who start entering into AMIE or who is planning to take up the exam. So lots of difficulties were there. But now all the senior members of AMIE students, okay, all the senior members joined together and formed a forum, okay. They started a website called amiestudy.com through which they started serving the juniors, okay. So this was running around past 16 years, okay. So this was started by the seniors to help the students who are coming to join, take up the exams and join the AMIE class. Okay, what's the benefit of the website? Why should I join? Classes are designed to complete AMIE in minimal duration class. So here we have designed classes, okay? So the classes are designed to complete AMIE in minimal duration. That is very much important, right? So all of you guys, most of you all will be working, students and many more businessmen, okay? Lots of appointments you'll be having. So you won't find time to go to regular classes on weekdays and sit and study, isn't it? So we understand your issues and we design the classes to work with your with you guys, okay, to benefit you. So that is, we finish the class in minimal duration and the cost is also minimal. That should be the main reason, isn't it? So that if I'm going to have a minimal duration and if my cost is going to be high, not all the students will be benefited, isn't it? So we see to that our quality, our cost and our time, all the three, cost and time is minimal, quality is high. Okay, students can join the classes from anywhere around the world. So you guys would be aware, since it is an online class, so everyone across the globe can join the class. Record session facility enables working students to watch the session at their comfortable time. What does this mean? Say for example, on a particular class, you are not able to attend the class. If you have a scenario that you have to skip the class. In that scenario, we provide a recorded session which helps you to watch what is happening in the class at your own comfortable timing. That is, the class will be recorded and it will be uploaded in our website. Okay, so whenever you want, you can click on to the link, look into the class. Am I clear? Am I clear, all of you all? Now, thank you. benefits. What are the benefits of this online class? See, apart from giving you recorded session, you need to every day look into the content, isn't it? See, if it is an normal classes, as you go to the school or colleges and study, you will have a book. Whenever you find time, you can open the book and read. Yes, similarly, same pattern, we give study materials, okay? What does this mean? The classes which I am going to take, okay? The classes study material is uploaded in the same website in the form of PDF. Once you download the PDF, you can look into the material whenever you want, okay? So, you can study even offline. So, we give recorded session, we give study material also. Please note, recorded sessions are available for 1 year. Previous question paper is discussed at the end of the class, which gives a clear picture of the AMIE question paper pattern. So, what do we tell you here? So, what do I mean here is, so once I finish the class, once I finish entire syllabus, I'll allocate one or two classes, okay, at the end. So, previous question papers, we take and we start revising. So, what happens when I revise the previous question paper? You can understand how the pattern is, what type of questions. You can get a blueprint of the question paper, right? I think you guys are aware of what a blueprint is, right? So, which question comes from which chapter? How many questions from this chapter? So, all that is a blueprint. So, even actually when I'm handling the classes, I'll be telling you what all questions are repeated questions, what all questions are important. As I handle the classes, I keep on telling you, please note it, please take it as important something. I'll be giving a small hint. Apart from that, when we are discussing previous question paper, you get a blueprint idea. Good morning, Mahalik, okay? I'm sorry, Mahalik. If I'm wrong with your, with my pronunciation, I'm sorry. Next. Periodical tests are conducted to ease the preparation of exam and boost confidence. What do I mean by that? See, once I finish 3 chapters, we give a test, we conduct a test on those 3 chapters. And if the chapter is going to be very big, we take that chapter separately and we conduct a test. So what happens, while you're taking up the test, you become well-versed in that particular chapter or set of chapters. Right? So you get the confidence in you. So while examination time, you just have to give a glance. You don't have to sit, break your head by learning the chapter or set of chapters. Am I clear? So, periodical, and I would like to tell you, when I give periodical test, you have to take the effort in preparing it. There lies the real concept, isn't it? So, you have to prepare for the test and take up the test. Once you take up the test, at the end of the classes, that is at the examination time, your workload will be very easy. Next. We also give assignments. The last point you can see, we give assignments which helps the trainees to prepare out of syllabus questions. So I would like to tell you a small information that you get few questions related to the topic little bit outside the syllabus. Okay, there are questions. And when you look into your teaching planner, I will be handling teaching planner. In that you have a chapter called C and C++, okay? So programming topics, C programming and C++ programming. So what happens there? They give programs and they ask you to give the output, or they ask you to write the program itself. So we give assignments for all those such things. Assignments in C programs, okay? In C++ programs, and out of syllabus questions also. We are aware, right? That is why we tell you that we are 16 years old people. So we track what is happening. So we know what are all important questions, what are all questions outside the syllabus, how do they ask, from which books they prepare the question. Apart from your books, if they are going to pick up outside syllabus questions, we know from which books they are picking. So we would recommend those books also. So in last class and all, I have told my students, if you are going to do a research in this topic or look something extra, if you are searching something extra for this topic, I tell them the book. Okay, take this book with the author name. If you are planning to buy or download from the internet, look into it. So outside syllabus questions are given from particular books. We also tell you the name of the books. If you have time, you can refer those books. If you are so thirsty in knowledge, right? Fine. So I told lots of stuff, but you need to know a track record, right? So here you can see from our slide, 100% our results are proved. In winter 2013 to 2016, our success rate is 95% for Section B and 78% for Section E. And we don't stop with that. We are not happy with that. We are still improving to achieve full 100%. Okay. And we are improving on our teaching techniques. Fine. So after that, this is high time to look into how to enter into the class. Okay. So how to enter into the class? All of you all should know. But anyway, it's my duty to explain, isn't it? So registered students will be given a user ID and password through which you can enter into the class. So after this first session, if you are going to register or if you have already registered, you would get a user ID and password using which you can register. After registering, using user ID and password, you can enter into the class. So once you have registered, weekly you will get an email schedule from our team, okay, about the class details. So after getting an email, what should you do? You should click on to the link, okay? We have given a user ID and password, isn't it? So click on to the link, enter user ID and password and enter into the class. Now you guys are into the class, isn't it? So you should interact. Good morning, Monu. You should interact into the class, okay? I'm not sir, I'm madam, okay? You should enter into the class. And after entering into the class, you can interact with the lecturer through the chat window. You guys are aware, you guys are already doing it, but for those who don't know, okay? Next, apart from chat window, you can also interact with the lecturer. How? Suppose if you want to give new ideas, okay? And that you cannot express it through chat window. That is, if you want to communicate orally, okay? Good morning, Shivam. If you want to communicate orally, you can get my permission. I will give you the mic access. Okay. So after giving the access, you can start speaking. So your interaction orally is also possible. Right? Fine. So I'll be explaining. Next part is, I'll be explaining everything through my board. That is, you can see on the screen, isn't it? This is a PPT. There is a whiteboard similar to this. I'll be writing what all I want to explain with the board also. Now suppose if you want to access the board, suppose I give a expression and if I ask you to solve, if you want to solve it, again I'll give an access to you guys, writing access. Once you get the permission from me, okay, you can also express your views through whiteboard. Right, so interaction is possible not only through chat window, through mic and through board also. Okay? Right, guys? Now, step-by-step guide to enter into our portal. So, our website is, you already know, vle.amiecoaching.com. Once you click on to the link, okay, you will get a link schedule from our admin team. Once you click on to it, it will ask for user ID and password. The screen will appear like this. Once you enter into this using user ID and password, next screen will be like this. Okay. So computer science, material science, design and manufacturing, and all the other subjects follow. Okay. Society. So whichever subject you have enrolled, click on to that. Okay. Today we guys are into my subject, computing and informatics. It's seen on the top, right? So you have to click onto it. See, 14W1 hyphen computing and informatics. It's like that, isn't it? So what is this 14W1? These are all my previous batches. What does that 14 indicate? Year, okay? Our year is 2017. We have taken 17. This is a winter batch, so W1, okay? Just click on W1 hyphen, it will be computing and informatics, okay? So you'll get a link like this. You have to click into this link. Once you click into this link, next screen will be like this, okay? You have a top link called recorded session and a bottom link. Is my voice breaking for everyone? Is my voice breaking? No. Fine. Then just one second, guys. Please refresh. Okay. So issue is in your end. Please refresh just one. Fine. Okay. Guys, look into the screen. So this is the screen wherein the last screen will appear like this. Okay. First link is recorded session. Second one is 17W1-CI-001-22072017. What does this mean? I'll write it here so that it will be clear for you all. Okay, it's very small. 17, it is like this. W1-CI-001-22-07. Can you guess what does this mean? Can you guess what does this mean? Perfect, guys. That is all. Very good. So 17 is the year, W1 is a winter batch, this is the class number, first class CI-001, date on which this class is held. Okay, so why I'm telling you this means, this is our first class, so this is the only link you have to click. As days go by, you'll have lot of links, so you should click on to the last link, that is, you should identify with these criteria, okay. So next screen will be like this. So you have to click on to the enter class button. You have here, you can see enter class button. Once you click on to that, you will be into the class in which you are right now. Okay? Clear with how to enter into the class, guys? Any doubts? Even if your doubts are so silly, you can ask me because we are here to answer your queries. Right? So don't hesitate if you have any issues regarding how to enter into the class, please post it right now. Okay. Next. Thank you. How to use the recorded session facility. So already just now I have told you, suppose if you are not able to take up the live class, that is if you are not able to enter into the live class, we provide a recorded facility. Just now I told you, right? So we can look into the recorded option and look and listen into the class. So how to enter into the recorded session? We are going to see now. So already I have told you, you have a login ID and password, isn't it? So using your login ID and password, you can enter into our recorded session facility. Now, apart from that, you can also look into the study material. That is also uploaded along with the recorded session. Okay? So already I have told you, right from date of registration, you can use this facility for 1 year. Okay. Now, how to enter into the recorded session? Topmost, you can see a link. You can see, right, recorded session link. So, can you see this? It's very small, mind you, because I have lots of link here. Yes, you guys can see recorded session link. Yes. So, you have to click on to that link. Once you click on to that link, next screen will be like this, wherein it gives you a list of all the previous finished classes. 14S1 2014 summer batch, the date. Okay. So if you want to look into that, I have to click. Why have I uploaded the previous batch? Because this is our first class for us, isn't it? So that's why I've given the previous batch details. So if you want this, click on to this link. Once you click on that link, you'll get a window like this. Click here to view the recorded session, and on the right corner you can see a PDF. If you want to listen to the online class, you have to click here to view the recorded session, or if you want to download the PDF study material, you can click here. Right? Done. Any doubts here as to how to enter into the class, how to look into the recorded session? Am I clear? So any questions about us, please be free to ask. No? Okay. Next, I'm going to introduce you all to our teaching planner. So what does that mean? See, the class which we are going to handle, it is for 2 to 3 hours, okay? Depending upon the topic, our classes will increase, it will not decrease, okay? So usually, it takes 20 classes to finish the topics. If I need extra classes also, during weekdays, I'll handle, okay? Because our computing and informatics topic is very vast, very vast. So the 3 year subject which you're going to study in the college, you're going to study here for 6 months. And that too in a weekend classes, right? So according to that, keeping that in mind, we have prepared the teaching planner. So we'll see the teaching planner now. Group A, your entire computing and informatics syllabus is divided into two, group A and group B. Okay. To start with group A, it takes 20 hours. Okay. First topic is computer programming, approximately 1 hour. And the time mentioned here depends on the batch, guys. Okay. If you are going to, if all of you all are going to cooperate with me, the topic will be finished in 1 hour. Here and there, it may take a little bit, half an hour or 1 hour extra, depending on the students. Okay? I hope you guys understand. Computer programming, 1 hour. What all topics covered here? Programming concepts, program development process, characteristic of a good program, program plan. Next topic is algorithm and flowchart. It takes 1 hour. Here we are going to discuss about algorithms, flowchart, algorithm and flowchart design. That is, we take a program and we are going to look into the entire program step by step, and we are going to design an algorithm and flowchart for it. Right? Third one is programming languages. Again another 1 hour. Here we are going to see perspective, basic perspective of programming languages, its application perspective, methodological perspective, design perspective, dialectal perspective, and implementation perspective. Next, fourth topic is C programming language. It takes solidly 4 hours, because here I'm not going to teach any theory. Here I'm going to teach you how to write a C program. So my assumption, almost 90% of my students in the class would be totally ignorant of programming, if I'm not wrong. Okay? So I have to start from the scratch as to what an algorithm, what a flowchart, what a program, everything. Okay? So it will solidly take 4 hours, and I'll also put a plus here. Okay? Here we are going to discuss about introduction, built-in functions, special operators in C, arrays, functions, control statements, formatted input output, C preprocessor, pointers and structures, graphics. So according to this topic, I would like to give you some more information that this chapter doesn't stop in the class. As I've already told you in the introduction PPT, I told you that there I told you that I'll be giving assignments, right? So accordingly, in C program, I'll be giving you assignments a lot. That is, I'll be giving lots of program for you to do it as a homework. So before that, I would insist you to install WC editor in your home, and I'll give you assignments. Your duty is to write the C program, practice in the C editor, get the output and send it as a mail. Getting what I'm trying to tell? You'll be writing a program literally in C, in the editor. That's what I'm trying to tell. Am I clear? So this is going to be a live programming practice for you. So in case if you have any doubts, you can ask me through email. I'll reply. If you also have chat options, messengers, lot of chat messengers, I'll help you through that. Even then, if you're not able to solve the program, at the end of the session, I'll ask you to install some software like TeamViewer, etc. So what I'll do is, I'll get into your PC using the TeamViewer and I'll solve it remotely. Getting me? So even after sending email, even after chatting, if you're not able to solve the program, okay, I'll take your PC as a remote connection and I'll look into the program and solve it. So you're going to write the program on your own using Turbo C editor. You'll be looking into the output and everything will be pakka. In case if you have any issues, we will solve it remotely. Okay. So this chapter will get a lot and lot of attention. Am I clear? Why? Because they'll be asking you C programs in your exam. Okay. Next is C++ object-oriented program. Exactly the same as what C program is. Advanced C is your C++, isn't it? Same attention will be given to C++ also. So what is this? Here we are going to learn what is C++ programming, object-oriented approach using C++, features of C++. I'm just moving to next page, etc. Okay. Next is introduction to Pascal. Though Pascal is a programming language, according to our syllabus, it is a theoretical concept. Here we'll be looking into the introduction to Pascal, elements of Pascal, input-output in Pascal, control statements, arrays and subprograms in Pascal. Any doubts still here in our teaching planner? Coming to the informatics part, little bit of theory. So here our seventh chapter is information system for decision making. Here the topics covered are decision making, information system, decision making and information system architecture, computer and decision making. Eighth chapter is data management and database management technology. So again, an important topic. It takes 3 hours. Okay. Here we are going to see in and out of as to what is the data is, how the data is managed, where it is stored, how to work with the data, everything in and out related to the data we are going to see here. The topics covered are data management terminology, file processing and database management technology, types of database, SQL querying for database applications, popular DBMS. So all that we are going to see here. Next is office automation system. Okay. Here what we are going to see is conventional office system, modern office system, what is office automation technology, application of office automation. We are going to see about IP for office automation and we are going to look into Microsoft Office. What is Microsoft Office? Okay. Next topic is computer networking. Another important topic, as I've already told you. It takes 3 hours. So here we are going to see about networking of computers. What is an autonomous computer? Computer and networking. Types of computer networks. Network services. Overview of TCP/IP. Hello, Dharmendra. Next chapter is Information System for Business. Here the topics covered are digital business, types of information system for business, new forms of business, strategic information system, information resource management, various issues in information system for business. Okay. Now coming to Group B. So we have seen all the topics in Group A. Now we are going to enter into Group B. In Group B, we are going to see the basics of computer. The first chapter here is history, generation, classification and architecture. In this topic, we are going to look into the history of computer, look into the generations of computer, we are going to see classification of computers and the architecture of computer. Coming to next topic, number systems. What is a number system? Some mathematics topic we are going to see here. When I say math, don't think a big math, a small concept. Okay. Concept of zeros and ones, binary number system, what is binary arithmetic, complement representation, representing information on digital computers, error detection and correction in codes, octal and hexadecimal number system. Right? So we are going to see all that. Next is Boolean algebra. Algebra, we have heard somewhere, isn't it? Where have we heard this word algebra? Any idea? Yes? Let's have a small interaction. Algebra, we have heard somewhere, isn't it? In which subject? In high school. Good. In which subject? Good. Max. So that is brought down here. Algebra, what you studied in your school days, is related here. Okay. We are going to see Boolean algebra here. Why should I study Boolean algebra here? Simple circuits. Very simple. So here, introduction, Boolean algebra defined, Boolean relation, sum of products, product of sums, algebraic simplification, minimization of Boolean expression. So all these we are going to see here. Coming to the hardware part of section B, here we are going to see introduction to logic gates and flip-flops. So introduction in that topic, positive and negative logic, combination logic circuits, sequential logic circuits. So all these are we are going to see here. It takes about 2 hours. Coming to next topic, components of computer. We are going to see about the hardware. We are going to study about the hardware of the computer. Okay. What is CPU? What do you mean by clock and synchronization? What is memory and storage systems? Input device and output device. Clearly we are going to see in this topic. Coming to the software part of this, here in this section, we are going to see system and application software. What do you mean by system? What do you mean by application software? We are going to see that introduction, then system software, what is application software, all that we are going to see. In chapter 18, we are going to see what is a compiler and translator. Okay, the topic is all about compilers and translators. Here we are going to see what is language translation? What does compiler mean? Other translators and what does interpreter mean? We are going to study about all compilers and translators in chapter 18. It's going to take about 2 hours. Next, the last topic is introduction to operating system. Very important topic. We are going to study about the operating system in this topic. Topics covered are introduction, types of operating system, operating system functions. What are all popular operating systems? MS-DOS, Unix, Windows. We are going to see about them in detail. Any doubts still here? So this is our teaching planner. as I already told you, see, we have 19 chapters to complete. Okay, apart from that, we'll be giving a periodical test, we'll be giving assignments. With all that, we'll be preparing you excellently for the exam. So only one thing we require from your end is cooperation, right? So once you give your full cooperation, okay, we can excel. What do I mean by we? Both of us can achieve. So we'll also achieve by giving a good result. You'll also achieve by getting a good score, right? Any doubts here in our teaching planner? Shall I start with the topic? So I'm going to take a whiteboard. Before getting into the first chapter, let me give a small introduction about computers. Okay, many of you all would be aware of what a computer is. Maybe one or two may not be aware of what a computer is, isn't it? So for those who don't know, I'm going to give a small introduction. So all of us are using computer. When I'm using a computer, what is the architecture of that computer? Can you all tell me? Can anyone discuss the architecture of computer? The block diagram at least. Can anyone tell the block diagram of the computer? Yes. See guys, please don't hesitate to interact through the chat window. Even if you're wrong, I keep insisting my students, even if you're wrong, please enter it. Don't feel ashamed or don't feel bad. All of us are here to learn, isn't it? Including myself. I'm going to learn something new from you all. You're going to learn something from me. Okay. Even if you're wrong, please reply to chat window. We learn from our mistakes, isn't it? So please don't hesitate. Please don't think that anyone will think like this or that. Okay. Nothing like that. Good. Jyoti, very good. Monitor, CPU, keyboard, mouse. Prashant, monitor, keyboard, mouse, CPU. Good. Deepika, input, processor and output. Mono, mouse plus monitor plus, good. So all these, what you guys told me is perfectly right. So combination of all these is a computer. Now let me draw the block diagram with what you guys told. My computer has three boxes mainly. Okay, let me tell you, we have three boxes. Okay, first box is called the input box, last box is called the output box, the middle box is called the CPU. So basically my computer is divided into input unit, CPU and output unit. Am I clear? The computer is divided basically into three types: input device, output device and CPU. Deepika can't see the whiteboard. Others can view the whiteboard? Let me move back and come. Yes. Now Deepika, now is it visible? Deepika, please refresh. Yes, Deepika, please refresh, you'll be able to view, because all the others are able to view, so you have to refresh in your end. Good, she has gone. Now, looking into the CPU, further classification of CPU is into three. I sub-categorize the CPU into three. The CPU is divided into ALU, good, control unit, and memory unit. Once again, I'll repeat. CPU means central processing unit. That is the main backbone of your computer. So all these points you guys are aware, but it's my duty to tell. So CPU is divided into three: ALU, control unit, and memory unit. What does ALU mean? Arithmetic logic unit. Okay. So what does this arithmetic logic unit does? It does the calculation. the name itself tells you, isn't it? Arithmetic logic unit. So this arithmetic logic unit does the calculation. Control unit. From the name we can understand it controls the entire system. Memory unit. What does your brain do? Memory. It stores your information, isn't it? Your memory stores information. Similarly, the memory unit in the CPU stores the data and retrieves it back whenever you require. Got it? Now, how this entire unit works together? We'll see. Suppose if you're going to input a program or you're going to type something, command, if you're going to give some command to the input unit, what happens? The input unit sends the request to the CPU. Okay? The input device sends your request to the CPU. Once the CPU, the central processing unit, requires your instruction, in the central processing unit, who's going to catch your instruction? The control unit. Okay? The instruction you give through the input device. What is your input device, by the way? Your keyboard, your mouse, all these access your input device. Okay? Through your keyboard, if you're going to input any information or any command, those commands reach the CPU, the control unit of the CPU. Okay? The control unit understands your request. And in your request, if you're going to send a request to do an addition, okay, suppose you're going to write a program to add two numbers, that is an addition process, isn't it? So that calculation part is sent to the ALU by the control unit, okay? Your calculation request to add two numbers, that request is sent to the ALU by the control unit. So the addition of two numbers, 5 plus 2. What is 5 plus 2? 5 plus 2, what is 5 plus 2? Very good. 7. So result is calculated as 7 and it is sent back to the control unit. The ALU performs the calculation and sends the result back to the control unit. Now, what does the control unit do? It takes the result and stores it in the memory unit. Fine. Suppose if you are asking the computer to display the output now, the data that is stored in the memory unit, that is your result 7, is taken back by the control unit and it is sent to the output unit for display. Am I clear? So what happens? The result of adding two numbers is displayed on the monitor. You can see it on the screen. Getting me? So, I'll just repeat once again. The program, you're going to write a program to add two numbers, okay? That is keyed in through your input device, okay? Your program is sent to the CPU. The control unit takes the request, okay? Then what happens? The calculation is done in the ALU. The result is transferred back to the control unit. The control unit sends it back to the memory unit for storage. And later on when you are planning to see the output, or if you are going to see the output instantaneously also, the control unit takes the output and displays it on the output device. That is your monitor. Is my voice clear? Can everyone hear me? Okay. Prashant. Prashant, right? Yeah, yes, go on. Fine. Thank you, guys. So, is this clear? The basic information? Good. So, this is the block diagram of the computer and how the computer works basically to the code. Am I clear for everyone? Yes. So, this is how your computer works. Now, next what we are going to see is, next basic information about computers what we are going to see is, your computer has its own language. See, you guys have your own language, right? In India, we have different languages. Each state has more than one language as mother tongue, isn't it? So there is Telugu, Malayalam, Kannada, Tamil, Hindi, Oriya, Gujarati. The list is on and on, right? So we have lots of mother tongue languages. Likewise, computer also has its own language, and you call it as binary language. Heard about this? Heard about this binary language? Yes. What does that mean? Can anyone tell me? Perfect, Deepika. When I say binary language, it has only two letters. Yes, only two letters. What are those two letters? 0 and 1. The binary languages has two letters. One is 0 and other is 1. Only with these two letters, your computer is going to understand what you're going to talk. What does this mean? The combination of zeros and ones make up the language. So when I say 0, it is off state. When I say 1, it is on state. You have your switches at home, isn't it? Just connect it with that switch. If I'm going to press downwards, it's going to be on. When I'm going to press the switch upwards, it's going to be off. If you want to switch on the fan, I'll press downwards, on means 1. If I'm going to press upwards, I'm going to switch off the fan, means off. Right? So that is your 0 and 1 literally indicator. Okay. Now furthermore, if I'm going to explain further concepts in binary language, how am I going to indicate? The combination of zeros and ones. 100. 101. 1101. 0101110. Something like this. Just with a combination of zeros and ones, I am going to express, I in the sense here the computer, okay? The computer is going to express everything in its binary language. Just with a combination of zeros and ones. Am I clear? Yes? I hope this is clear with everyone. So please say yes or no through the chat window. Only through that I understand your views. Right, guys? Fine. Now, I've written something here. 0101110 100 101 101. What does this mean? Can anyone interpret? Maybe since this is a small number,